Narerigu Gambaga constituency in the North region have threatened not to participate in the December 7 general elections. They claim politicians have taken them for granted since 1992 and would only turn out to vote this year if challenges of roads, water and farm inputs are addressed.
Gambaga is one of the notable towns in the Narerigu Gambaga constituency. It lies north of Tamale and was the capital of the northern region until independence. The area is noted for its agricultural production, tourism and culture. Yet, the constituency remained undeveloped as a result of inadequate attention by successive government.
You know, we have bad roads, we are lacking of water facilities and a whole lot of things. If they have started doing maybe working on our roads and then started providing us maybe means of water, we will know that maybe when they come to power, they'll be able to do more than that.
When it comes to election time, they say a whole lot of things. But saying something is different from doing it. And now we the people, we've come to a realization that we're not going to move by their words, but we'll take the decisions we ourselves based on what they have said and based on what they have done. We still lack schools. We have sanitation problems, so we strongly believe that if we give them the nod from 2017 onwards, those issues will be addressed.
Roads linking the constituency are in deplorable state as residents continue to rely on unwholesome water sources. This is the state of a dam constructed at the western end of the Gambaga township. Residents say the water is only used for construction work and by cattle. The inhabitants have no choice than to commute over 8 kilometers to access water from this well and river.
And the politicians too, sometimes they are just deceiving us. That we should vote for them. We will vote for them and they win and go. They won't come back here again. The time that you see them, unless we are about to go through election again, before that they will come back here and be deceiving us again. They will just come and lies. We should vote for them, what and what. When we just do that, when they just go, that's all.
Again, of more concern is employment.
And this?
Yeah, the main occupation in this community is farming. And most of the farmers, they are peasant farmers. So because of that, the youth and they engage in farming. And even looking at the what they are doing, comparing to the cost of farming is also a problem. A bag of fertilizer is too costly, it's too high, comparing to a bag of maize. And because of that, it is affecting the youth. Out of frustration, some of us are engaged in drinking, others we are engaged in smoking, and all that social vices.
Others called for subsidy on agricultural input, as well as the creation of market for their produce.
Agriculture in modern times cannot be reliable because even with a huge land which has been farmed on for more than 100 years, without money to buy fertilizer, you really come out with nothing from the farm. Yes, so it is the rich who make it and the poor remains poor.
Some residents have some advice for President Mahama in particular.
The president is a listening president. She do what you want. Anything you request for the president to do. People are talking there's no job, there's no job. One, there's no projects. One, there's no place for you to go and work. Will you just go and sit on the tree to work? You cannot go and sit on the tree to work. So the projects must come out before the work will come. So everybody should be patient and let the projects to finish. When the projects finish, everybody will be equally to get the work to do.
A prison officer admonished the electorate to promote peace and not lose hope in the future.
For the peace there, I hope there will be peace during after the election. Yeah, I hope our big men or the service commanders used to talk about peace. And we the young guys or we the young officers following them, I think we to map on the strategies just to maintain peace. So I don't think there will be chaos in the country.
Until these are done, politicians are likely to draw point in the Narerigu Gambaga constituency if the threats of the resident are anything to go by.
That'll be all for Mission tonight.